अनम्यूट।
ओके सॉरी, या इन बाइनोमियल कोएफिशिएंट्स लॉट ऑफ क्वेश्चंस आर देयर रिलेटेड टू बाइनोमियल कोएफिशिएंट्स, सम थिंग्स वी कैन ओनली टेल थ्रू द फॉर्म ऑफ क्वेश्चंस देन द थ्योरी। ओके, वी हैव इनगो आई डिस्कस सम थ्योरी, ईदर इंटीग्रेशन और डिफरेंशिएशन और यूजिंग सम सिग्मा नोटेशन एंड ऑल दैट। ओके, वन मोर थिंग वी आर नॉट कवर्ड earlier, I guess some idea for some other question, but it's okay. You can write this formula in your class notes. You can just continue this theory. Even if you are doing odd numbers, you can stop and just write this theory. MC 0 into NCR plus MC 1 into NCR minus 1 plus MC 2 into NCR minus 2. So on up to MCR into NC 0. So one binomial is about M, another binomial is about N. Here R values increase, here R values decrease, and every time sum of the R values is R only. This is M plus N C R. Proof. I'll take 1 plus X whole power M into 1 plus X whole power N is equal to 1 plus X whole power M plus N. This can be written as 1 plus or MC 0 plus MC 1x plus MC 2x square plus MC 3x cube, so on. This is NC 0 plus NC 1x plus NC 2x square plus NC 3x cube, so on. This anyway normal 1 plus x whole power M plus N. Equate coefficients of x power r on both sides. Equate coefficients of x power r on both sides. How will you get x power r here? Here constant into x power r term. Here x power 1 into here x power r minus 1. Or here x power r into here constant. That is exactly this question. You will get directly MC0 into NCR. MC0 means first time here. NCR x power r means x power r coefficient that will give you. Another one is MC1 NCR minus 1. That is x coefficient here, x power r minus 1 here. That will give you x power r. So this is MC1. MC2 into NCR minus 2. So on MCR into MC0. You will get the question as it is. And what is the x power r coefficient in the binomial expansion of 1 plus x whole power m plus n? Is m plus n cr. That's all. I don't have to write this. Same as the question. Just equate quotient x power r on both sides. You'll get the answer. Yes, please.
Sir, yesterday you were telling one formula and you stopped in the middle, sir.
What is that?
A into NC0 minus A plus D into NC1 plus A plus 2D into NC1.
Oh, I did not give the proof. Okay.
Yes.
Okay, I'll give it. All right. Sorry, I have to ask in the beginning. Did all of you leave some gap for that or no? Okay, you can write the formula once again. Anyway, I'll discuss something about this, then we'll come back to the topic.
Yes.
Please turn on your videos. Lot of people videos are off. All of you have to write your first year IP exams, sir.
Huh? Yes, sir.
Optional, sir.
Okay. Did NRS talked about anything that in the class?
Yes.
Yes, sir.
They said optional. Those who want, they can write.
No, sir. Everyone.
You don't compulsory.
Compulsory, everybody should write. Okay.
Yes.
When are the exams starting?
September 15th.
September 15th. Okay. So you'll be kept any pre-board exams or directly you'll write on your own?
No, no, sir.
Okay.
Sir, told that we have a time from 1st, sir.
What? September 1st onward?
We'll like sir will give us time to revise, sir.
Okay. Okay. Anyway, I think now 1B is very easy for you, right? 1B, straight lines and all, and differentiation and all, they should be very easy. Maybe you have to revise a little bit of pair of straight lines. Regarding 1A, trigonometry should not be a major issue. Maths and determinants and vector algebra, you have to revise. Okay. In one way, it is good. At least we don't have to revise those first year topics for JEE mains, along with IP prepare for JEE mains also, especially vector algebra and maths and determinants. Okay, I'm erasing this. I want to write another group. Okay, proof 2. Consider m fruits of one kind, m distinct fruits of one kind. Comma, n distinct fruits of another kind. Okay, so total we have m plus n fruits. In that, m fruits of one type and n fruits of one type. I want to select all fruits out of this. But that has many ways. You can take 0 out of this, r out of this, 1 here, r minus 1 here, 2 here, r minus 2 here, r here, 0 here. Okay, so we have to select r fruits out of n plus 1 fruits. Okay, that can be taken 0 here, r here, 1 here, r minus 1 here, 2 here, r minus 2 here, r here, 0 here. That's all. You just said this much. After percentage combination lesson is over, you come back, you'll understand this proof. If somebody not able to understand this proof, don't worry. Okay, just write it. That's all. We have to select R fruits out of M plus N fruits. Okay, everybody completed this? Okay. Okay, next question. NC 0 square plus NC 1 square plus NC 2 square so on up to NCN square is equal to 2NCN. NC0 whole square plus NC1 whole square plus NC2 whole square plus NCN whole square is 2NCN. This is also like formula. I'm telling you the question or formula, doesn't matter, both are same here. Okay. This one is actually very easy. In IP exam, we have to write method 2. But what is method 1? It is NC0 square. I can write NC0 into NC0. NC1 into NC1. NC2 into NC2. And NCN into NCN. Just now, based on the formula that I said, you can use the previous formula, but sum of these two, sum of these two, sum of these two, sum of these two should be same. Now, then only I can use that formula, right? Even now, I can use that NC0. The second NC0, I'll write NCN. NC1, this NC1, I'll write NCN minus 1. This NC2, I'll write NCN minus 2. And this NCN, I'll write NC0. So every second NCR, I wrote it as NCN minus R. Now, sum of these two is N, sum of these two is N, sum of these two is N, sum of these two is N. This is increasing from 0 to N, this is increasing from N to 0. This is like NC0 into NCR, MC1 into NCR minus 1. Then will I get N plus N, C, sum of these two is N. Am I right? M plus N, CR, M is N, N is also N. So you got 2N, CR. Okay, this is because already I derived the previous formula. But in IP also, sometimes in exam, they give this question. It's not what you are expected to do it. I am going to take 1 plus x whole power n into x plus 1 whole power n equal to 1 plus x whole power 2n. Expand this, what will come? This is correct because x plus 1 or 1 plus x doesn't matter. This is nc0 plus nc1x plus nc2x square plus nc3x cube, so on. This is nc0 x power n, nc1 x power n minus 1, nc2 x power n minus 2, so on, equal to 1 plus x whole power 2n. When I multiply these two, tell me what is x power n coefficient?
nc0 into nc0.
nc0 into nc0. What about nc1 into nc1?
Yes.
nc2 into nc2. Because this is x square plus x power n minus 2. Together you will get x power n.
Okay. Okay.
So just to equate coefficient of x power n on both sides, you will get nc0 whole square plus nc1 whole square plus nc2 whole square, so on up to ncn whole square. What is x power n coefficient in 1 plus x whole power 2n? If you take 1 plus x whole power 2n, yeah. If you want x cube coefficient, 2n c3. If you want x power 7 coefficient, 2n c7. Like that, x power n coefficient is 2n cn. That's all. Okay. In IP exam, the second method we are expected to write. If somebody is looking in solved examples in IP, you would not find x plus 1. Sometimes you will write 1 plus 1 by x. Instead of x plus 1 here, if I take 1 plus 1 by x, you know what will happen? Here I will get 1 by x. 1 by x square, that is, here I'll get nothing, here I'll get 1 by x, 1 by x square, so on. You will find the given question is constant in this product. Then in 1 plus 1 by x whole power 2n, you have to find constant. When you find that, you will get 2n cn. In the place of x plus 1, I'll erase the upper part. Maybe I can even write that as method 3 if somebody wants. Okay, method 3. Take 1 plus x whole power n into 1 plus 1 by x whole power n. It will be 1 plus x whole power 2n by x power n. You take LCM here, multiply. Is this correct? Is the statement correct?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now let us expand this. Expand this. This will come NC0 plus NC1X plus NC2X square, so on. This is NC0, NC1 by X, NC2 by X square, NC3 by X cube, so on, equal to 1 plus X whole power 2N by X power N. Okay. Equate constant on both sides. Equate constant. A term independent of x on both sides. Here, this into this, here this into this x will cancel, this into this x will cancel. We'll get nc0 whole square, nc1 whole square, nc2 whole square, so on up to ncn whole square. In this, if you want constant, already denominator x power n is there. If you take numerator also x power n, it will get cancelled. So you have to take 2n cn x power n by x power n cancel, that is a constant. So these two should be equal. So I chose to write x plus 1 here. These are more or less same. I just took LCM and cancel x power n there. So basically, the mc0 and ncr, when one series is increasing, one series is decreasing in the r values, you can take 1 plus x and 1 plus x, not a problem. But when it's like nc0 to nc0, nc1 into nc1, nc2 into nc2, okay, better to take one like this and one this way, or one like this, one like this. I think this time board exams is there's no gap, every day one exam, right?
In between Sundays there's.
Okay, but otherwise normally they give one alternate days, not like that. I think first is in the morning and second is in the afternoon, something like that. Huh?
This order is given consecutive days. Only for physics they gave a Sunday on.
But otherwise, every day you have exam. One day math, one day, there is English, Sanskrit, math, one day. Math. In 6 days straight, it will be over, except the Sunday, right?
Yes, sir.
So. I don't know whether in all IITs or not. Many times in IITs, when they keep either final exams or mid exams or whatever they call it, mid sem exam or something. If you have to conduct 5 exams, it will be over in 2.5 days. Morning one exam, afternoon one exam. It will be done. If they keep like that, they can finish your IP exams in 3 days, right?
Yes, sir.
They will finish, but we won't be able to write, sir.
No, prepare well before. What is there? Same number of days only, prepare well before. So you don't have to carry on for 15 days. I think the CBSE exams is sometimes, I don't know, about 10th class, but 12th class exams, one day math will be there, physics will be after 10 days, chemistry will be after 12 days, like that.
Yes, sir, for us also, 1 week we got maths, we have got 10 days, sir, for 10th yeah. class.
That is stupid, for so many days, you know, when things postpone or stays for a long time, we'll not be able to handle. Okay, what is there on the board? I'm going to erase. Anybody needs more time? Okay. Those who completed, write this question. Show that 20 C0 whole square minus 20 C1 whole square plus 20 C2 whole square minus 20 C3 whole square, so on to 20 C20 whole square equal to. What is the answer also? I am not telling. Okay. Alternately, plus minus. 20 C0 whole square, 20 C1 whole square, 20 C2 whole square. Okay, I am not given any formula for this. But you have some idea about the method based on the previous two questions. Just think about it. Okay, anyone want to give an idea how to get alternately plus minus? What are the two binomials I have to multiply to get this?
Sir, 1 minus one. X minus X whole to the power n into 1 plus X whole to the power n.
Yes. If you take both 1 minus X also not good. You take one of them, 1 minus X whole power 20. The another one is 1 plus X whole power 20 equal to 1 minus X square whole power 20. A plus B into A minus. Okay. When you expand this, 20C0 minus 20C1X plus 20C2X square minus 20C3X cube, so on. This is 20C0 plus 20C1X plus 20C2X square, so on, equal to 1 minus X square whole power 20. No, I should not take 1 plus X here. Better to take X plus 1 here. Otherwise, one of them is constant, one of them x square, one of them x power 4, there is no use. So, you take 1 minus x into x plus 1, not 1 plus x. So, that I will get 20C0 into x power 20, 20C1 into x power 19, 20C2 into x power 18, so on. Now, when I compare x power 20 coefficient on both sides, compare x power 20 coefficient on both sides, you will get the question is equal to, what is the x power 20 coefficient in RHS? Anybody want to tell? In 1 minus x square whole power 20, what is x power 20 coefficient?
20C10.
Yeah. What is x power 4 coefficient in this?
20C2.
Yeah, if you want x power 4, you have to take square here. So it is 20C2, not 20C4. So like that here, it is 20C10. Power 10 of x square will give you x power 20. So here answer is 20C10. I hope everybody is able to follow the concept that we are discussing today. We are trying to multiply two binomials, and LHS is product of two binomials, RHS is single binomial, and we are trying to compare some coefficient. It is giving some result. So we have to get an idea what binomials should be taken and what coefficient should be equated on both sides. Okay, those who completed, try to find answer for this. 30C0 whole square minus 30C1 whole square plus 30C2 whole square, so on up to 30C30 whole square.
Sir, 30C15, sir.
You may need a small correction, think about it.
The 30C20.
No.
No. So 30 is 15.
That's what he said in the first place.
Sorry.
Minus 36.50.
Yes, it is minus 36.50. Because when you take power 15, you have to take minus x square whole power 15, right?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, so answer is minus 36.50. Okay, equate coefficient of x power 30 on both sides. You will get question equal to 30c15 minus 1 whole power 50, which is 30c15. Okay, another question. 27c0 whole square minus 20c1 whole square plus 27c2 whole square minus 27c3 whole square minus 27c27 square. Okay, so here answer is minus 30c15, the previous question, because of minus x square whole power 15. So this is completed. Try to answer this. Do you want to tell what is the answer for this?
Sir, can I guess, sir? 0.
Answer is 0. Okay. The answer is 0. Why? First and last will cancel or not?
Yes, sir.
Second and last but one will cancel. Okay. 27 method 1, 27C0 whole square is same as 27C27 whole square. Similarly, 27C1 whole square is same as 27C26 whole square. First and last are opposite signs. Second, last but one opposite signs, they'll cancel everything. They'll get 0. Method 2, even if you do by that all this method, then you get 1 minus x square whole power 27. What is the x power 27 coefficient in that?
0.
0, because only even powers exist. So coefficient of x power 27 in 1 minus x square whole power 27 is 0, because everything will come x square whole square, x square whole cube. Only even powers, odd powers will not come. That's the reason it is 0. Or you can understand first and last will cancel. Earlier you could not do that because first and last are getting added up. Both are same sign, but here first and last have opposite sign. Okay, another question. A into NC0 whole square plus A plus D into NC1 whole square plus A plus 2D into NC2 whole square, so on up to A plus ND into NCN whole square is 2A plus ND by 2 into 2NCN. Before that, the last term is A plus ND into NCN whole square. Anyone want to give an idea how to do this? Without that arithmetic progression, we're done. Now, an arithmetic progression is multiplied to it.
Sir.
Yes, please.
We will take it as then reverse the equation and add again.
Yes. Same like how we derived sum of n terms of an AP. It was a series in that. I can write for last time first, A plus ND into NCN whole square, A into NC0 whole square. A plus ND I cannot change it, but NCN I can write NC0 whole square. And A I cannot change it, but NC0 I can write NCN whole square. If I add this and this, okay, so 2 times LHS, I'll get 2A plus ND into NC0 whole square. 2a plus nd into nc1 whole square and 2a plus nd into ncn whole square. Okay. So 2 times LHS is equal to, if I take 2a plus nd common, I'll get NC0 square plus NC1 square plus NC2 square, so on up to NCN square. Divide with 2. You will get 2A plus ND by 2. And this is anyway 2NCN we derived. Okay, everybody clear? Can I erase this? Okay. Anyway, not this. Before this, we had done 3 questions. 20C0 whole square, so on, alternative plus minus. 30C0 whole square, alternative plus minus. 27 C0 whole square. Okay, I should have combined them, given one formula. So I'll write it now. NC0 whole square minus NC1 square plus NC2 square, so on, minus 1 whole power N into NCN square, alternative plus minus. It is equal to two things. N, C integer, not integer part. NC N by 2 minus 1 whole power N by 2. If N is even. And 0 if N is odd. Okay. When you took 20 here, answer came 20 C10. When you took 30 here, answer came 30 C15 with a minus. When you took 27 or 29 here, answer came 0. All that is together here. Okay. So instead of telling this first, I told you the three questions so that you'll get an idea. This proof is very easy. Now you can write 1 minus x whole power n into x plus 1 whole power n equal to 1 minus x square whole power n. This is NC0 minus NC1x plus NC2x square, so on. This is NC0x power n, NC1x power n minus 1, so on, equal to 1 minus x square whole power n. Compare coefficients of x power n on both sides. Then you'll get NC0 square minus NC1 square plus NC2 square minus NC3 square, so on, equal to coefficient of x power n in 1 minus x square whole power n. That is two things. NC n by 2 minus 1 whole power n by 2 if n is even. NC n, no, it is 0 because odd power doesn't exist. If n is on. Okay, so the three examples that I gave, so that you will get an idea that you can understand this proof more easily. Otherwise, okay, now I'll discuss what I left in yesterday's class one last point. Please turn on your videos. Everybody could understand this proof?
Yes, sir.
Within 10th class, you studied in which school?
Priyanka Sudhyada High School.
Okay. You have done any foundation till 10th class?
No.
Okay. Amit Kartikeya, where you studied 10th class?
Sir, Shivishivani Public School, sir.
You have done any foundation?
Sir, 1 month I did, after that I did, sir.
Okay. Sriharsha, you studied in Kolkata, right?
Yes, sir.
You have done any foundation anywhere?
No, sir.
Okay. Vidyalakshmi, you studied with school?
Sir, Bastion.
Mm-hmm. Isn't that some foundation is there?
Yes, sir.
Okay. They taught any intermediate first year topics or 10th class topics only in depth?
Intermediate first year topics, somewhat.
Like trigonometry and differentiation and all?
No differentiation, sir.
And maybe straight lines and all.
Yes,
Dinkta, we studied with school?
The Navy Children's School.
Okay, we have done any foundation?
So for a few months in the beginning of 10th class I did. After that, when boards came close, I left.
Okay. What about in your 9th class?
No, sir.
Okay. Rochan Srivastav, where did you study 10th class?
KKR Gautam, sir.
Okay, in hostel?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so the, I think you learned some intermediate topics before only, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay, what is there on the board? Can I erase this whole thing?
Yes, sir.
Okay, yesterday last I gave this that A into NC0 minus A plus D into NC1 plus A plus 2D into NC2 minus A plus 3D into NC3 at the last minus 1 whole power N will come. I cannot reverse the series and add because I don't know whether last term is positive or negative. How to deal with it? One method is you can write a sigma A plus RD. NCR minus 1 whole power r. Put r equal to 0, r equal to 1, so on. Now split it. This into this separately, this into this separately. A into NCR minus 1 whole power r and r into D into NCR minus 1 whole power r. Here if I take A common, I'll get sigma NCR minus 1 whole power r. Here r into D. This NCR, I'm going to write this by this into 1 less that formula. N by R into N minus 1 C R minus 1. Why? So that I can just cancel this R into minus 1 whole power R. Now when I expand the sigma for this, I will get when I put R equal to 0, NC 0 minus NC 1 plus NC 2 minus NC 3 so on. And coming to this, I can take N D. I can even take one minus common, but I will not do that. There is no point in putting r equal to 0. When I put r equal to 0, it is 0 anyway. I should also write that r equal to 0 to n. This is r equal to 0 to n. Here, better write r equal to 1 to n. Because anyway, r is 0. Okay, this is 1 to n. This is 0 to n. Here, when I put r equal to 1, I will get minus n minus 1 c 0 plus n minus 1 c 1 minus n minus 1 c 2. So, okay, this whole thing is zero. Whenever you take binomial series, complete series, all positive answer would have been 2 power n. But alternately, positive and negative means it is zero. And coming to this, this is complete series of n minus 1 c binomials. C0, C1, C2, everything alternative plus minus. That is also zero. N d into zero will get zero. So whenever you have alternately plus minus into some AP, mostly it is zero. Even sometimes you may have a square of this also. Okay. Because either you are differentiating it once or twice or adding two things. After differentiating, you are going to put x equal to 1 only. It's going to be 0. Whereas in integration, when you put 0, something may come. So when it's alternately plus minus and especially differentiation related things, most likely it is 0. When it is integrated thing, you may get to one or two small expressions. Okay. Okay, I can somehow manage to do this by differentiation. How is that? Earlier, whatever I took, x power a into 1 minus x d whole power n. You expand this and then differentiate it, put x equal to 1, you will be getting this.
Sir, what and is that expression, sir?
Binomial, this is 1 minus x power d whole power n. If I expand, what will come? NC0 minus NC1 x power d plus NC1 x power 2d, so on, right?
Yes.
When you multiply x power a, you'll get x power a here, x power a plus d here, x power a plus d. Now differentiate it, you'll get a here, a plus d here, a plus d. You'll get the question.
Yes, sir. So that's just a suitable expression, sir. Not formula.
Yeah. That is, this is a formula. This is one proof, this is another proof.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So usually people do by this method one that I say, but you can always do method two and say question is equal to d by dx of x power a into 1 minus x t whole power n at x equal to 1. Even if I apply UV rule and put x equal to 1, it is 0 anyway, because you'll get x power a into n into 1 minus x power d whole power n minus 1 minus d x power d minus 1 plus a into x power a minus 1 into 1 minus x d whole power n at x equal to 1. When I put x equal to 1, this is 0, this is 0, so the whole thing is 0. Sorry. So 0 plus 0. Okay. Okay, we will stop here. You can try even number in the mains material, or you can wait, or IT first exercise we have to complete. Okay. Tomorrow I'll discuss odd numbers starting from 37 or something, where whatever properties we discuss, when we done some questions, you'll get a better idea. Okay. Still, I have to teach few things, better to tell in the form of questions. All right. Thank you.